The best way to get sound from an Arduino is with a separate audio decoder. In this video, we'll show you how to use the DF Player Mini to play MP3s. In fact, the Arduino itself is pretty bad at playing audio directly, so go ahead and buy this $10 audio board and save hours of headaches. This frees up the Arduino to do other processing, and you don't have to worry about buffering issues from your storage device. All the files in this project are on the GitHub repository linked in the description. These videos take time and effort to make, so please like and subscribe to give this small channel a boost. There are two modes of operation. One is using a small speaker that you can connect directly to the DF player, and the second is using an op amp to give your sound a boost. Let's compare the two. Okay, we're going to talk about how to set up the Arduino with the DF Player Mini and its most basic setup, just using a direct speaker connection with a low watt speaker. So I've got a little teeny speaker here, and we'll be trying to connect this up. I like to connect the Arduino with a 9 volt battery, and we'll show you how to connect that. Essentially, what we have is the DF Player Mini already soldered onto a board here that I'm using for a different project. I have it mapped basically to these pins here for external connections, but the pin numbers are a little bit different, so I'll talk through the DF Player Mini pins as we go through it. The first thing that we can do is I have a 9 volt battery connector here, and it has positive and negative on it. So let's hook this up to our board. So I have red here for plus 9 and black for our ground. And essentially, we need to take that over to our Arduino board too. So if we take those same connections, the ground and 9 volts, we can take the 9 volts and stick it in our VN, and our ground, put it in ground, and the Arduino. Now, the advantage of this is it gives us a 5 volts and a 3.3 volts. So it actually down converts the voltage the Arduino does. So the next thing we can power on is the DF Player Mini. And that requires a 5 volt source. So to power up that, we can take the 5 volts from the Arduino and we can put it on this blue here. And all that's gonna do, you can see this red wire, is it just runs to pin 1 of our DF player. So that's gonna give us our 5 volts here that we need to power it up. And then obviously this ground also runs to pin 7 on the DF player, which is also the ground. Okay, so we basically have the DF player powered, and now we need to hook up the speaker and the data wires. So the data wires are basically pins 2 and 3. The first one, pin 2, on the DF player is your RX, and the second one is your TX. So let's put these here. So again, this is pin 2 and pin 3 on your DF player. It's shifted just a teeny bit with these. Now the thing that I noticed when doing this is that the RX and the TX are actually opposite when you get to the Arduino. So we'll take this orange one, which is the RX, and that needs to go to the TX on the Arduino. So I'm going to put that here, and then I'll put the RX on the other one. Okay, so like I said, these are actually switched as they come in here. So I'm using actually the TX3 and RX3. So we'll, in our software, we'll have to denote that we're using these two connections. Also note that there's a 1K resistor between the RX and the TX pins in the Arduino. And this is because if you read the data sheet, they say this helps reduce noise. And then finally, what we could do is take our speaker, and those would go to pin 6 and 8. So here's pin 6, here's pin 8. So you can connect this speaker directly to it. Now I put those two just on the very end here. And that should do it. So let's see what happens when we plug in the battery here. Okay, now we're going to show you how to connect up the op amp version of the DF Player Mini. So we're looking for a little bit more oomph. The last version was probably more for just testing, and this version will be a little bit more for crowded areas. I've got the same circuit that we started with, and all I'm going to do is take off the speaker, that little speaker that we had, and we'll take that away right now. So when we introduce the op amp, I've got it already here. You can buy prefabricated op amps, but this one, we have the circuit diagram for you in the description, and I've already soldered this one up. So to start out with, we need to provide power to the op amp. For this op amp, we're just going to use the 9 volts coming from our 9 volt battery. So I'll just take our bus that we had our 9 volts on. Actually, I'll use white for ground. And we'll hook up a wire here. So white is ground and purple is your plus 9. Okay. So that should power up the op amp. And then our next two connections are our speaker. So as you can see, we've got a bigger speaker back here. It's a 10 watt speaker, 4 ohms. And we can connect this up through these wires here. It's just a plus and minus on the speaker. Awesome. And then the next connection is your input. So our input is basically going to come off the DF Player Mini, and it is pin 4. So that would be for your external op amp. This is actually stereo, so there's two outs, but you can use pin 4 for mono. So the output of the DF Player Mini is pin 4, and we'll pop it onto here in our circuit. We'll catch the input there. And then all we need is, finally, we have a volume knob. This is kind of a large one, but we have three connectors here. And we could just hook those straight into our pre-soldered circuit here. All right, so now all only changes we've made to the circuit are that it's going into the op amp, it should drive the speaker, and we have a volume knob here. So let's plug it in, see what happens. We can turn it down. And as you can see, it's much louder. So obviously you would want to go with the op amp if you had any sort of real aspirations of creating a project that people could hear in a crowded room. But obviously the direct connection with the speaker is good for testing. So let's go through the code really quick that matches this project. So the code essentially will play a series of MP3s, seven different files that represent the notes A, or that represent the notes C, D, E, F, G, A, and B. So this is basically the DF Player Mini's stock code, but it's modified just a little bit. So I'll show you the differences in this version. First thing is, in the pinouts, I use the TX3 and RX3. So here you can use Serial 3 when you initialize the class. Again, this is all kind of stock code, so I'm going to scroll through. One of the things that I had to add an onPlay finished was this little stanza here, and there's an issue with the Arduino where it'll try to play the same note twice at the same time, and it'll error out because it can't grab the buffer in time. So what this does is it just keeps a clock, and if it tries to play the same note within 200 milliseconds, it returns. This is pretty important because it was getting very erratic behavior without this stanza. If you go to the setup, it sets up the serial, prints out the properties of the DF player, which I think is important because if it's not set up properly, these will all be zero and you can debug from there. But one of the things you can do here is set the volume. So if you're using the speaker directly, this is the only way you can change the volume. But when you have the op amp connected, you obviously have the potentiometer. So then it prints the number of files that it found on, and so the files are actually under a folder called /mp3, and they're named 001 mp3, 002 mp3, etc. So when it starts up in the setup, it plays track 1, and so that would be kind of how it's named. And then after it finishes, it comes back to this. So once track 1 finishes, it says onPlay finished. So it'll go into this method and essentially increment the track and play track 2, 3, 4, 5. If it gets to 7, it starts over. So that's pretty much it. That's all for the code. It's pretty simple. These videos take time and effort to make, so please like and subscribe to give this small channel a boost.